Hey everybody, this is Jacob. I wanted to do a review on 2002 Sonny, starring James Franco, and it's directed by Nicolas Cage, written by John Carlin. You guys, if you watch my videos, you guys know I hate making videos like this where I'm talking in front of the camera, but I made a whole video about this, and like many videos, it got blocked for copyright infringement. If you guys want a copy of the original video with the footage over it and just me reading my script, you guys can send me your email. In case you're interested, probably not. But okay, so Sonny is about James Franco. He plays a male prostitute. He comes back. It's in 1982. Yeah, it's 1982, and he comes back from the Marines. I think he's in the Marines, something to do with the Army. And he comes back home to New Orleans. His mom is a madam in a brothel, and he tells his mom used to pimp him out. And she's been pimping him out since he was a little kid. And when he comes back from the Marines, it's been a couple years. He tells her, "I'm not going to do this anymore. I'm going to get a regular job. My friend from the Army promised me a job, and I'm going to go work at a bookstore." And she tells him, "No one's going to want you, and who the fuck are you to think you're not better than me?" And really, it's a really sad scene. But then the job doesn't work out, and nothing works out, and he basically goes back to the life. And his mom has this woman named Carol, who she also pimps out, played by Mani Sarivi. She's an American Pie. I can't pronounce her name. Mani Sarivi, but she's an American Pie and Loser and Spun, which I'm also going to be reviewing really soon. And American Beauty. She's an American Beauty. But her and James Franco fall in love. But then she tells him, "I want to leave. I don't like this life, and I'm going to get out of here. You should come with me." And he tells her, "No." All right. Like, basically, he's just afraid to fail again. And so she says, I met this guy. He's one of my tricks. And he has to marry me, and I'm going to leave with him unless you leave with me. I don't want to leave with this guy. He's disgusting, and I hate him, but I got to get out." And he tells her, "Yeah, I'm not leaving." And the ending, she leaves with this guy, but then it shows her, like, in kind of a typical romantic movie fashion, which I'm not faulting it against. He chases her and she gets out of the car, and then it burns white with like their heat, white, it burns white with like their passion, and it shows James Franco just standing there. Like, I would assume it looks like he just imagined it, and that was a perfect ending, him not going and chasing after her. And I love that ending. But I just listened to the commentary on the DVD. I bought this at Amoeba Records in Hollywood a couple years ago. It has two commentaries, one with Nicolas Cage and his longtime producer, Norm Gulatry. And I think they have a company together. Another one is the writer, John Carlin. And John Carlin really makes it sound like they ended up together, that he gave us a happy ending, because when him is believing it is not a happy ending. So I'm just really confused on that ending. But Nicolas Cage, his commentary is much more... I'll get into the writer's commentary after, but Nicolas Cage's commentary is much more technical. And he says, "No interpretation of this film or any scene is wrong. Just take what you want from it." So I'm going to choose to believe that James Franco, Sonny, did not go chasing after Carol, and that he let her go, and they both go on to live their pretty miserable and sad lives, you know? And I want to talk about some three major scenes. Basically, there's the three major scenes, all of them were James Sonny snaps. And the first one is when his friend from the Army tells him the job went under. It was my dad's bookstore. My dad is dying of cancer. I think he died of cancer, and he lost the bookstore. But he says, "You know, I got a double date." And James Franco's like, "I've never been on a Sonny." It's like, "I've never been on a date before." And he's like, "What? Why?" And he's never been on a date that he wasn't paid for. So he's very awkward and like doesn't know what to do. But the date goes good, and he has great sex with this girl. And then he opens up to her and tells her, "I'm a prostitute, and I'm not anymore. I'm done with that life, and I like this life better." And he just like, he's like a child or a baby, like holding his mom, and she's scared. It's too honest for her, and I relate to that scene so much. Basically, every girl I've ever liked or loved, I've had that moment where I just was way too honest, and it freaks them out. And it's their first date, and she is probably afraid that she just caught a venereal disease or STD. So then she's drinking cough syrup, goes in the bathroom, and he's just freaks out on her. And you know, this scene was so, it was like a punch in the face when I saw this scene. When I first saw this movie, I can't remember exactly how old I was, but I remember it was late night on HBO when I was like six. It must have been in middle school. That's like my best movie experiences. I couldn't sleep in the middle of the night in middle school or high school when I watched these crazy movies on HBO. There's so many great movies that changed my life because, like, I had that experience, and this was one of them. And it was just, whoa, the scene is so brutal. And I remember one time I showed my friend this movie. He said, "Why is he so mad?" And I'm like, "What do you mean, why?" He explains everything. It's so... This movie... I don't understand. Some people are confused by this movie or Sonny, and I just understood his character so much. And I just understood the story. But this scene really changed how I looked at artists and actors and just... I don't know. Like, I think artists and actors. Because I remember... Well, when I was a kid, my uncle used to put me in a... He was a film student, and he used to put me in his movies. And I remember thinking, why would anybody want to be an actor when they can be a director? The actor is kind of like the puppet. They just have to do what the director says. The director has the final say. He chooses out everything. And the actor just kind of has to do what he says, you know? I remember that was my mentality as a child. Because I always knew I wanted to make movies. And but then I remember watching the scene in James Franco... There's something about, like, they're all naked, and it's just so vulnerable. Sorry, I hate using that word. But, I got bad speech. That's why I don't like these videos. But, there's just something so raw and open about that scene, and it's scary. Sonny is scary. James Franco is scary in that scene, and, but I remember watching that scene thinking, this is why people become actors, so they can do this. You can't do this if you're a director, and it's also probably a reason why some directors... But it's probably why Nicolas Cage wanted to make this movie, to film someone do this scene, something like this, you know. And it's a great fucking scene, man. And it was just like, whoa, it's intense, and I love it. And then the next scene is when he dresses up like a cop and pretends to be a cop for this trick with this old woman, and older woman, she's not too old, but he goes in her house and he acts like a cop, and then he sticks like the baton, the Nike stick, up her vagina. He's so disgusted and humiliated, and it's such a degrading, dehumanizing scene for him. And then she wants to dehumanize him even more after she's like had her fix or whatever. She got off, you know, and she tells him, "I'm only gonna pay you 200 and he's like, it's three, and she's like, "Well, I'm only gonna pay you two, and he ain't having it. He breaks her TV and he starts breaking her shit, and she's scared, and she goes, "Take it, you whore." And she gets a last laugh because she crumbles up the money and calls him a whore. And he's got nothing to say because no matter what, she wins because she's a respected woman with money and he's used up whore. And they use that. Sonny calls himself a whore. His mom calls him a whore. They don't ever use the word prostitutes or anything because that's what they know. That's what they are. People pay them for sex. They're not paying them for love. But Sonny is like, he knows what he's doing. Not even just like sexually, romantically. Like, you could tell he has this one old trick that he's been known for years, and you could tell she really gets like romantic. She has like romantic feelings for him, and she really likes him. Like, she, I don't know. I think it's a little bit more than sex. She's like everything she would want. But then she degrades him a little bit. And then the third scene is the final scene. Okay, so he loses. He didn't know that Harry Dean Stanton, who's in the movie, didn't know that was his dad until after he died. He didn't know who his dad was, and then his mom tells him he was your father this whole time, this man, and he's like, "You fucking should have told me." And man, he's intense when he's looking at his mom and she's telling him that scene, when she's telling him this, because he didn't. So it's real, but it's not her fault because she wanted to tell him, but Harry Dean Stanton, Henry, who's such a fucking amazing actor, he told him, "If you ever tell him that I'm his father, I'll leave and I'll never come back, because I don't want him to know that his father's a failure." And then he gets drunk, out of his fucking mind drunk, and he ends up at like a gay prostitute house. This gay whorehouse is run by Acid Yellow, played by Nicolas Cage. And I just want to tell people, Nicolas Cage did not want to be in this movie, but the people who gave him the money said, "You have to be in this movie or else we're not going to give you the money." So he kind of reworked this character as being someone he wanted to play, or someone he thought it would be good. I think in the original script, it was like just a random Mexican guy who just happened to run a whorehouse. And then the jacket that Nicolas Cage is wearing, Acid Yellow, it's his own jacket that he bought at an auction of owned by Liberace. I think I just thought that was a fun little trivia fact. But then, so he's gonna be with this guy, and he asks the guy, "Do you know your father?" And the guy's like, "What?" And he's like, "Well, mine's fucking dead." And he kicks him in the face, and he runs out, and they're gonna kill him, but he runs out. And then the ending happens. But okay, so when I first saw this movie, I watched it like most kids watch scary movies. They were like this. I was like, "Oh God," because it's a movie about James Franco playing a prostitute, and yes, he's sleeping with older women, unattractive women. It's not like American Gigolo, or with Richard Gere, where he's sleeping with all these beautiful women. No, he's sleeping with like people who look like your aunt or your grandmother or your mother, you know. And but the whole movie, and so I'm thinking, okay, he's sleeping with women, but you know it's gonna get gay at some point. It's just a matter of time. It just has to happen. And oh God, and it's like it was really uncomfortable. I remember I let a girl borrow this movie, and she was like, "That movie was uncomfortable. I liked it, but it was really uncomfortable to watch." So you're watching it, and I'm just like, "Oh God!" And he's at the whorehouse, and you're just like, "How far is this gonna go?" And oh my God! And I was a little homophobic more as a kid. I think I'm not as much anymore. Definitely not as much. But as a kid, you know, it's part of it. And then when he just kicks him in the face, and it turns into that, and it was like, "Oh my God! You did this scene so perfect." It was like a horror movie where it just, I don't know, something about how it makes you fear that scene is going to happen, and then it erupts into the scene of great violence, and it works with the story. It was so fucking perfect, man. I thought it was perfect. Okay, but I want to talk about the writer of this movie, John Carlin. He died in 2015, but he what's written online about him is that his mother, his grandmother ran a house of prostitution and crime, and prostitution was just one of their criminal activities. And she pimped out, she pimped him out as a young man, and he went to prison, and he wrote this, wrote his very first screenplay, which is this, called Sonny, in 1977. And, he used it to go through Hollywood, but he couldn't get it made. But, he made a few, like, made-for-TV movies. I know he made one about Robert Mitchum. I think it's about, like, a cop story. I kind of want to check that out to see how good it is. But, so he wrote it in 1977, and when Nicolas Cage started becoming like kind of a movie star in the mid 80s, he found the script and he started bringing it to studios saying, "I want to be in this movie. Can we find a director?" And no director would commit to it. So eventually he just kept trying and trying, and he told and then he got too old where he's like, "I can't play Sonny." And so he decided to direct the movie, and he directed it in, must have been 2001 when they finally filmed it. So this was a movie really him and the writer John Carlin had worked on for years, at how they were going to tell this story. And you could feel that in the movie. You could tell this is every single decision was pre-planned and thought of. Every character was thought, everything was, they knew these characters and the story like the back of their hand. And you know, John Carlin is just such an interesting guy. He was a crime consultant on this movie called Straight Time, starring Dustin Hoffman and Harry Dean Stanton, where they rob banks. And that's what John Carlin went to prison for, armed robbery. And I actually just bought Straight Time. I should have it mailed to me in a couple weeks, so get ready for a review on that. I watched that movie once years ago, but I remember really liking it. I know Quentin Tarantino loves that movie. He showed Robert De Niro it when he was making Jackie Brown with him. So get ready for a review on that. And but yeah, John Carlin, and I was waiting for his commentary. It's a great listen, but I was waiting for him to get personal and tell his life story. But he's really just really emotional, like telling all the characters' decisions and why they do the things that they did, and like their backstory. And it was just like, whoa, getting to really know these characters. He knew these fucking characters, because I think he says it's not based on a true story, but it's obvious that Sonny was, he was very close to Sonny, like he could relate a lot to him. And that's kind of every writer, you write something that's very close to you, you know, and every character is, every star of your movie or your screenplay is a part of you, and you could tell Sonny was a big part of him. His basic, so I'm waiting for him to tell it, but it isn't until the very end credits that John Carlin basically sums up his life, that he was a prostitute, pimped out by his grandmother, he illegally joined the army, but he was underage, so they sent him back, and then he had to go back into prostitution for a bit, and then he went into armed robbery, and he went to prison, and then when he went to prison, he became a writer, and his whole life changed after prison. And yeah, he's just a really interesting guy. And it sucks that he died in 2015, because I would like to know more about him. But so this movie and this audio commentary are basically the closest I think anybody's ever going to get to knowing him who didn't know him in person. So I'm really glad for this movie and listening to that commentary. I recommend, if you really like this movie, I recommend it. And I actually just bought this poster. I just framed it yesterday. I used to have another poster of it, this Japanese poster, really rare, and I couldn't find it, so I had to just bought this one. But I want to tell you guys, I know Tommy Wiseau, the director of The Room, who James Franco plays, and The Room, the disaster artist, Tommy Wiseau let James Franco make that movie because he loves Sonny. That's like one of that was the movie he said to James Franco, that's why I'm gonna let you do this movie, because I loved your performance and I fucking love that movie. And the audio commentary of the disaster artist, James Franco asks him, why do you like this movie so much? And he says, you know, because it's in New Orleans and it's so powerful and you're naked. And James Franco's like, I'm naked? What are you talking about? And I gotta admit, James Franco doesn't seem like he really likes this movie that much. He doesn't care for it too much. But aside from Freaks and Geeks and his James Dean, the movie he played James Dean, he never says anything positive about any movie he did before Pineapple Express or Milk. I think it's a personal thing about his where he was at it in his career. He was listening to other people's advice. But I don't know, man. This is my type of movie. It's not a movie for everybody, but I just love everything about it. I love the New Orleans setting. I love all the actors and the characters. Of course, James Franco, like Nicolas Cage, describes him as being like having the emotions of this character at his fingertip, and he could cry on cue, and he was just so blown away by James Franco's performance. And James Franco's that kind of actor, man. And I love James Franco. He's truly one of my favorite actors of all time, and I miss him as an actor. I really want to see him in more movies. Oh, I want to show, I made a video about this, but I want to show you guys this in person. I recently bought this a couple weeks ago. It was an issue I've been trying to get for years. It's Interview Magazine, I think December 2002, after this movie came out. Nicolas Cage interviews James Franco, and they talk about Sonny. But I did a whole video, nobody's watching it, where I read the interview, but I also, there's an interview with Brad Renfro and Johnny Knoxville. I read that too, so I recommend if you guys, want to read hear that interview, I read the whole thing. I play James Franco and Nicolas Cage. I don't do their voices because I'm not good with voices, but check out that video. I made it, and this is anybody who knows me knows I fucking love this movie. I love it so much. I just love, it's so character driven about like these really sad outlaws. And but the mother, Brenda Blethyn, I don't think she has a name. She's just the mother. She's just so manipulative. I hate using that word too, but she, to me, she's a monster. How she pimps out her son, and she just uses her son, and she's a monster to me, this character. And it really hits home when parents abuse their child, not even like mentally or physically abuse their child, but just use their child and take advantage of their children and for their own gain. I mean, it's just so sad. And the mom, the Brenda Blethyn, is such an underrated actress. She's a great actress, and this is a great character, a horrible person, but a great actress. And she's very interesting, a very interesting character. And so I just love everything about this movie. The only thing I have kind of mixed feelings now is listening to the audio commentary about the ending. Like I said, I'm going to choose to believe that Sonny did not chase Carol, and that she left with that disgusting man. So if you guys have ever seen this movie, let me know what you guys think about it. And if you haven't seen this movie, I thank you for watching this video, because I know people watch my videos who haven't even seen the movie, and I really appreciate that. Just buy this fucking movie, man. Just buy it. You can buy it online for like less than $20 on Amazon or eBay. So I really love this movie, and it's a really special movie to me. It really made me want to make movies, you know. It's a really influential movie in my life and storytelling. And it's very simple, straightforward. Just a character-driven story. And I love Nicolas Cage as a director. I don't think he'll ever direct anything else. I think this is the one thing that was so personal to him, because he had the script for so long. He just did it. And I'm okay with that. A part of me wants to see him make more movies, but I don't think he ever will direct another movie. And I've come to terms with that. And if this is his one movie, it's a great fucking movie, man. And I love Nicolas Cage. I love Harry Dean Stanton. I love James Franco. I love Brenda Blethyn. And I love Mina Sorvarghi. Sorry. I don't know how to pronounce the name. Okay, so yeah, tell me what you guys thought about this movie. And So if you want, you guys can leave comments about this movie. If you want to ever ask me about anything, you can. Go for it. You guys know how YouTube works. If you like this video, hit that like button. Subscribe to this channel. And you guys can follow me at Instagram at cinemajunkies_. Don't forget the underscore.